I was just picking some things up and putting them down. Today I wanted to talk to you a little bit about the kettlebell. We're going to start this out by talking about the kettlebell deadlift because it's really the foundation of a lot of what we do with this. It's going to train your hips to move in an appropriate way. It's going to help you with your Olympic lifts and a lot of the power lifts we do here as well. So when we're picking up this kettlebell, the first thing we want to think about is our position. Our feet should be between our hips and our shoulders, and they should be pointed straight ahead. That bell handle right here should be right at the back edge of our toes, just about at that midfoot position. And when we pick this up, we want to think about keeping our entire trunk and head in line the entire time. So our head stays in line with our body as we do this, never crank up or look down. Picking this up, it's a lot like that deadlift. Our hips are going to track backwards, and our weight's going to be centered on our heels. As we do this, you want to think about taking those hip flexors and sucking those hips back. It's not just sending your butt back to do this. Your hands will be right in between your legs here, gripping the handle. Think about tensing those triceps and pulling those shoulders back and down. Your weight should be in your heels. Head is neutral. Get nice and tight. And you stand, opening those hips fully, opening those knees fully. And then you reverse that on the way down, sending those hips back first. The bell should end in the same position that it started in. A couple of things to really think about here when you're doing this is always keep that abdominal cavity filled with that breath of air, nice and tight. It's going to create an air bubble that's going to protect your spine. Breathing is key in any kettlebell movement that you do, including that deadlift. A lot of times people might think that this weight is light and they can sacrifice that form. But this same movement is what transfers to that Russian sweat. When you step back and hike that bell in and move it, it's that same angle that you're building. Next time we'll chat more about that Russian swing. If you have any questions, feel free to drop me a line, jason.murphy@albanycrossfit.com.